Hello everyone, this is Blaze, and today I have a bit of an... Well, I don't really have much. I'm really just here in my business skin, like we had with the whole trailer. That's actually a pretty good video. You should check that out. It's pretty good. It's doing really well on my channel so far. And well, basically, I just wanted to show you the finished project from last episode, which was episode 10. We did a huge, well, not, it was actually my shortest Voyagercraft episode yet, and probably going to be my shortest for a while. But yeah, so we basically did this whole big collab with the one, the only gray beast. So yeah, we got basically two spawners. I have my particles pretty much off right now because my computer just simply can't even handle particles, even when running Optifine, which like is just the best program ever for Minecraft and all that. But yeah, so as you can see, we got all these skeletons being funneled into there, and we got all these zombies being funneled into there. And we did set up some lights. I did that off camera, as well as funnel all the mobs into there. So yeah, we're just going to quickly kill these off, and then I'll basically show you all the redstone behind it, sort of. Yeah, I'm going to cheat a little bit and go into spectator mode. Oh my gosh. But yeah, let's just kill off all these real quickly. Do we have a sword with us? No, but we do have three diamonds, which we're not going to use to make a sword. We're actually going to use to make a pickaxe, because I do want silk touch. It's just something that, I mean, it gives you a little bit more extra guessing time, I guess, for if we ever do another mining session, which that actually gave me quite a few resources, so we might do that yet again. I mean, that's also why we were going to enchant some pickaxes to begin with. I mean, that's all I really wanted the pickaxe for. Oh, and if you do stand like right here, the skeletons start like shooting themselves because of like mob tracking and all that. But yes, as you can see, this farm is not so lossless. It's mainly because of this. Either the well, you'll see in a minute, but either the drops go all the way up to the top of the farm, not top, but actually the surface, or they will go up and basically go out. So yeah, we have a lot over here. But yeah, overall, not too bad of a farm. I mean, the main reason why we built this is because of the bone blocks and the rotten flesh trades, also because we actually did find a mending villager, so we got mending on my pickaxe. We did have mending on my sword before I I died, because it's just me. I mean, look at that many deaths. 39 deaths. Yeah. But yeah, we are raking in the bones, and also arrows too, but no one really uses bows too much. I mean, boom and maxed out dual use bows, but we are also raking in the armor. So yeah, we got tons of armor, tons upon tons and upon tons. And also, this farm does produce a very small amount of iron, because zombies and skeletons, I think maybe it's only zombies actually that drop armor, or not armor, but iron. My words do not seem to be working for mouth today. I don't know what it is with me, and maybe it's just laziness getting to my mouth as well, and I'm just trying to take shortcuts with speaking things. Yes, that makes total sense. Let's kill these guys off because they're holding bones, and we actually want these guys to despawn in a minute. So yeah, but yeah, let's take a sneak peek at the redstone. So slash game mode. Yep, so This is the whole farm. We got some crazy redstone going on down here. I did actually go into spectator mode while I was building this just so I can be more accurate in my predictions, and it turns out Boom did was working on a slime farm, so we have one of those now. It's not a huge one like we had last season, but it does produce. It's not the most efficient, but yeah. For some reason, he decided to make this weird staircase thing instead of just, I don't know, doing something. Actually, that's the first time that I did that. Also, Beast has been working on his house. That's going really well as far as I can tell. I might have ruined his time lapse a little bit. I'm not sure if he was recording at the moment, but yeah, I basically went to go see what he was doing because I got curious, and yeah. But here is why we actually went into spectator mode, to see the redstone. And boy, oh boy, did we basically stretch our iron supply here. We have recovered since then. Motorcycle. Darn you, motorcycle. Darn you, background noise to begin with. I mean, seriously. I pride myself on audio, and yeah. But yeah, so we got this little enchanting setup right here. We got the whole mob funnel right here. So basically, what I added as a nice touch was a few things actually. The toggle ability of these two farms. I mean, skeletons can be toggled to off or on, and zombies can be toggled from off to on. And for some reason, these guys didn't really want to stay off, so I had to put a little bit extra lighting in there. But yeah, zombies were pretty easy. And we do have this whole filtering system where, well, zombies were getting caught like right here, baby zombies, because we have a block right there and it's an air block. And so, yeah, we basically just had to dig a hole, and fully grown zombies will be like fall down here. Like if we slash difficulty peaceful for just a second, and then if we go like that, and if we like go travel to be zombie, like what they see. I mean, so basically what they will be doing is they're basically holding space bar all the time, so if they're fully grown, then they won't basically fall down into the hole. But if they aren't, well, they're not going to be, they're going to need a ton of neosporin, let's just say that. So yeah. Sorry for going into creative there. I didn't really do anything like give myself blocks, but I really just needed to demonstrate that. But yeah, we got the lighting, we got an 8-minute clip because I've just been rambling on and on, so we basically wasted half the episode. Sorry about that, but yeah. Not really too sure what we're going to be doing in this episode anyway, so yeah. Got all the redstone hooked up. Basically, just filling you in on what you didn't see last time. And we do have this whole item, not item, but mob elevator. I tried to make that visible just because I wanted to, one, make sure that it was working, and two, it just looks cool when you're AFKing and just watching zombies and skeletons go up there one by one. And let's slash difficulty. We're on normally, and let's game mode ourselves again. Survival. But yeah, so I'm going to just AFK for a little while, enchant a pickaxe, and then get out of here and get a mining session done. So yeah, wrong button again, darn it. I'll see you when that's all over.
That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change.
I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself...
Okay, guys, so we just got this silk touch pickaxe. It took quite a bit of enchanting to do, a bunch of throw-out enchantments that no one's ever going to use. And, yeah, we finally ended up with this Silk Touch pickaxe. We're going to put back our mending feather-falling depth strider boots. And over OP leather boots is what I'm going to call them. But, yeah, so we got Silk Touch on this pick. It took quite a bit, but yeah, we've actually managed to do it. So from now on, what we're going to do is we're going to get the ore instead of actually mine the block with the fortune. And just get the whole ore. Meh. You guys know what I mean. Okay, so yeah, basically what we're going to do now is I'm going to leave you guys for an hour. And I'm going to come back to just a giant chunk in the middle of nowhere, just filled with ores. Okay, so yeah, let's go find that chunk. Okay, yep. Oh, I thought my sticky. Yep, there's sticky keys. So I'll see you guys in the next clip. Okay, guys. So I just went mining for around about an hour. I wasn't really counting. I just remember looking at my clock at like 8:12 and now it's 9:22, and well, we got a lot of redstone on our hands. Keep in mind, we're going to be using a fortune 3 pickaxe and a mending, and that it also has mending on it, so we're actually going to repair it because I went pretty much all out this mining session, as you can see. Didn't get that much diamonds, sadly. We only got about 8 blocks of it. So, yeah, before you watch this next part, please go pause the video, go down, and tell me what you think I got. And maybe you'll be right. Who knows? So, yeah, let's just time-lapse this for a minute.
On my face,
and I'll be back.
I pick myself up and get back in the race. I can't deny it. I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. And if I didn't think it was worth one single try, I'd jump right on a big bird and then I'd fly. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself laying flat on my face, I just pick myself up and get back in the race. Big ball and die.
Okay, guys, I hope that you enjoyed that second time lapse of today. I think that was the second, right? The first one was of the, yeah, me getting the silk touch and all that. You guys know that, but I kind of forgot. So yes, what we got here is we got 2 blocks of diamonds. 1 diamond.
That's 8 grapples.
3 lapis. 37 blocks of lapis.
That's 6.5 grapples.
5 redstone. 2, pretty much 2 stacks of redstone blocks.
15.5 grapples.
We got 6 coal and 28 coal blocks.
That's 8 grapples.
So yeah, we are doing pretty well. So I am actually wondering how close you guys were. I do actually have some all my iron and gold smelting in this furnace over here, and it's all headed into here. So pretty much we have that much in there. We got 40 all still in there. We got, and we also have 34 gold still smelting. So yeah, that's the thing. It took more than a bucket of lava to smelt it. If you need, actually, I want to test something. Can you actually use magma blocks? Nope, you cannot use magma blocks. That is something that should be in like 1.11. Make it happen, Mojang. So yeah, let's real quickly sleep here so that we don't have to do that. Yeah, all this is from all the times that I was dying, and yeah, it was not, I mean, we gained 4 deaths in the span of an hour. So yeah, that should give you a rough perspective of how my mining trip went. So yeah, let's just do some quick organization of this. By organization, I mean throwing it all into here and somewhat aligning it with its proper ores and all that. So yeah, let's do that. Put that over there. So yes, this is pretty much all our resources. Let's actually make this look a little bit neater if possible. That would be great. Stack that, get that in there. We want that over there. I'll put that right there. The diamonds right there. So if you guessed that much, then you are correct. Or however many I have it up there, because yeah. So yeah, and also the iron and all that. So yeah, let's get right into the next clip. Well, guys, I know what we're doing. Okay, so basically this is pretty simple. Basically what I want to do is basically just to make a quick buck. I'm going to make this whole thing 100% what is it? Safe, yes. That way, boom, has to pay me, well, 10 diamonds. So yeah, that's an easy 10 diamonds for me, because I mean, all we really need is you know, some netherrack, maybe some cobblestone slabs, maybe. Depends on how, what I feel like it and how late it is, basically. So yeah, let's do this. Well guys, we might just have a death again. I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, I don't have particularly the best track record when it comes to dying. But yeah. We're basically fighting a ghast in the middle of nowhere. We're just off the path of Boom's tunnel. And basically, I'm probably going to die. So yeah, figured that you might want to... Yep. There it is. Well, I'll see you when I see you guys. Okay guys, so that's going to wrap it up for this episode. I hope you don't mind that we didn't really do that much except for get a bunch of resources, especially redstone. That's 3.5 grapples. I'm not really sure what he said there, but God, it just makes me chuckle. But yeah, so this is sort of like a maintenance episode that we're probably going to do every once in a while, just so that we can really just... It's a little bit of a filler episode while I'm in between projects and looking for something to do. So, yeah, leave a like if you did like this video and if you want to see even more of this type of video. If you are new to the commentary, please subscribe. It really does help me out. I'm almost at 70 subscribers, so that's if you are watching this like currently, like the day after it comes out, yeah, you'd know what I that reference, yeah. So yes, I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.